No one understands how hard it is to be over 600 pounds and missing a leg. Those two factors combined make getting around almost impossible. Right now, the prosthetic leg I use is barely able to hold my weight.
And every morning I have to fight to put a liner on over my stump. Then I have to be able to maintain my own balance. So I get shortness of breath from doing all the scooting and leaning up and all that. And it's pretty much impossible to ignore the pain and the aching and just the overall bad feeling, because my knee's killing me, my back's killing me.
So my weight, it's keeping me from having a life.
I've literally let my weight just drag my life down to where I'm at now. I'm almost 30 years old, living in my parents' garage, unemployed and having to rely on them.
I do everything for LB because he's my baby. He's my youngest, and I would do anything in the world for my son. That's how much I love him.
All right, I got your laundry.
There's days where I feel so worthless, I think.
I'd be better off in the ground.
So I just stay home and I don't go out. But the only time I do is if my mom makes me go help her.
Yeah.
LB.
What?
Come on, ride to the grocery store with me.
Well, I don't feel like going.
Well, we need to go get a few things and you need to get out of this house.
It's like once a month she really gets worried that I'm just wasting my life staying indoors.
I guess I can go. I'll be out there in a minute.
I got the car cranked up, so come on.
But it's hard on me. And barely doing anything leaves me
breathing like I just got done running a 5K.
And I start to sweat after just taking a few steps out the door.
I'll drive.
I got the air conditioning turned on.
And my prosthetic leg starts to hurt a lot if I stand on it for too long. So I try to get the trip over with as quick as possible. I also know my mom's gonna start getting on my case if I spend too much time with her. So it's best to try not to fight her.
But I hate coming to grocery stores because I feel like 20 minutes after I walk in, I'm gonna have a damn panic attack. Because my whole life I've always been, you know, one of the biggest people everywhere I've went. Then you add the fake leg into it and I'm a 6'4" bald pirate. Of course people are gonna look.
But once I start to get the things I want, I can calm down a bit.
When LB wants to get sodas and snack cakes and potato chips, it makes me feel awful. What am I supposed to do, tell him no? To me, that's the only thing left that he has.
I know my mom wants me to stop eating as much as I do. But it's funny, if I don't ask for something, she won't say anything. And she gets it for me. But if I do ask for something, she gives me this look or this tone. Then she gets passive aggressive about it. And I don't need that from her.
Will you grab a thing of the pepperoni pizza pockets?
Is that what you want?
You don't have to turn around and be a smart ass about it like that.
All right, you ready?
So when it starts to get to that point, I figure it's just time to go home.
I usually do the grocery shopping for him. I thought it would be good for me to try to get him out of the house and go with me today. I don't know if it was a good idea for me to do that or not, because I don't think he's too happy with me right now.
James Bonner?
Today I'm gonna see where my progress is at and if I hit my weight loss goals to get me below 392.
I'm happy with that.
I knew I was doing well, but that's a little better than I thought. I'm guessing the doc's gonna be happy with that.
Hey, Albie. All right, you lost 102 pounds over the last few months.
Yep.
That's fantastic. I'm proud of you.
Well, I can't thank you enough for giving me the tools I needed, so. My whole outlook's changed. I know for sure I never want to be the person I used to be when it comes to food or alcohol again. I never want to fall back into that.
Well, keep up the good work, because you're doing great.
I will.
All right. See you later.
Thank you. I'm so happy about today and how it went. I definitely feel like I've got all the tools that I need to win my battle with not only my weight, but my alcohol addiction. So I look forward to pushing myself a little bit more every day to make today better than yesterday. Been on the road for 2 days now. I decided that I wanted to go home to South Carolina for a visit. And I'm excited to see everyone and show them the progress I've made. But I'm also really excited because I'm going to get fitted for a new leg while I'm here. And I also have a surprise for my dad. So this whole trip is a big deal.
Seeing LB today has made me really happy.
We look so good. I'm so proud of him.
Now you can wrap your arms around him, can't you, Dee?
You look so good.
Still fat. There's just a little less of me.
A lot less.
I've had to add 3 belt loops and...
Right.
So. Well, we never
even
wallet
then.
Wait
a
minute.
Look good, bud.
Coming home and seeing all the support that my family gave me about the weight I've lost so far definitely made me feel good. I expected it to be over-exaggerated and really over the top, and it was a lot more genuine than I was expecting it to be. My new prosthetic finally came in. Because I've lost so much weight, I'm able to get a smaller one that's easier to use and doesn't cause as many issues. I can already tell it feels a lot better. And I'm hoping I can do something today I haven't done in around 15 years. I'm hoping I'll be able to start running. And if I can, that'll mean I can get even more active. And hopefully make progress even faster. But this is a little scary, because if I slip and fall, I can get seriously hurt. I'm exhausted, but that was awesome. I never thought I'd be able to do that again. A year ago, I was living in my parents' garage, over 600 pounds, and hardly ever leaving the couch. But I'm amazed at how much my life has changed for the better. The doc says I'll be ready for my skin removal soon. And after that, I'll be getting really close to my target weight. So, my future ahead is bright, and I'm excited about it. And I can't wait to see what it holds for me now.